A walk of just a few hundred yards down a most unremarkable stretch of road. These were the last known movements of Jodie Jones before she met her killer. Today, exactly a week after the 14-year-old was murdered, a police constable retraced those footsteps. Dressed exactly as Jodie had been on the night she died, she left the schoolgirl's home at 5 o'clock. The whole exercise took no more than a couple of minutes, but police believe it could provide the crucial lead.
There are many, many examples where reconstructions have proved the catalyst for major investigations, and perhaps some might not have given us the direct witness into the alleged attacker. It has put us on a line of inquiry that has taken us there at the end.
He then changed his statement, and by the time it got to court, it was totally different from the statement he provided at the start. In their first statement, they said that Luke's dog, Maya, was sniffing the air and was alerted to something. But then in the statement they used at court, the dog didn't sniff the air and Luke went straight to the V. And it makes it look as if Luke knew where the body was.
From an early stage, to make sure that they identified a suspect and arrested someone. But it is possible to lose important lines of inquiry by developing a case theory prematurely. That early closing of minds for the possibility of other suspects can result in lines of inquiry not being taken, which means then that to an extent the investigation becomes an inevitability in terms of where the finger points.
It's a horrible feeling of dread. What happened here was beyond terrible. 14-year-old girl murdered.
I do believe Luke Mitchell suffered a serious miscarriage of justice and was let down by the legal system. And he was also, in my opinion, let down by a jury. I can't understand how they could find him guilty beyond reasonable doubt at that trial.
I would take it one step further. 27 years as a police officer, my gut instinct has never let me down. I'm not basing my opinion or my assumptions on that gut instinct alone, but on the investigation we've carried out here. In my opinion, Luke Mitchell did not commit this crime, and he's innocent.